Hello everybody and welcome back on my channel. In this video I'm gonna show you how to make this double bearing bush and this exploded view animation. So let's begin. For this we have the next sketch, next drawings. We're gonna use this. So first part is the base, then is the cap, then is the bushing, and then the last part will be the bolt. So let's begin. First we'll open a new part in SolidWorks. Okay. And here we'll start a sketch in the front plane. Now we are making the base. Okay, so now we'll start with a center line, just like this, and then we'll select dynamic mirror entities and we'll select this center line. And if you don't have this feature here, just go here up to search, but first select here commands and here just write dynamic, and is the first one, and you can activate it from here or you can left click and drag it here. Okay, so now let's start with line. We'll make this sketch. Just like this. And now we have to define this. Let's close this dynamic for now. And now select smart dimensions and we'll define this sketch. Between these two points, here will be 45 millimeters. This line here will have 15. This line here will have 10. Okay. And from this line to this line, here will be 5. Nice. Okay, this is good for now. Let's give here a dimension. Here will be 70 millimeters. Okay, so this line here will have, actually from this line to this line, here will be 90 millimeters. Okay. Okay, so now we'll have to give a dimension for this line. It's a little bit more complicated, but I'm gonna show you how. So we've got here, let me make it bigger. We have here this line. This point is vertical with this, is colliner with this edge from this hole. We can see here that is tangent to this circle. So from this center point of this hole to this center point of this hole, the dimension is 60 millimeters. This hole have the diameter 4.5 millimeters. So if we want to know the dimension from this line to this line, which is the dimension for this line, we'll have to subtract from 60 millimeters this diameter of 4.5 millimeters. Because we have here half of that diameter, which is the radius from the center point to this line, this edge, and on this other side we have another radius, and one radius plus one radius, it's the whole diameter. So this line will have the dimension 60 minus 4.5 millimeters. I hope you understand it, what I was trying to tell you. So here will be 60 millimeters minus 4.5. Okay, now this is fully defined, but we'll have to select dynamic mirror entities again, select this center line, and now we'll have to make a center point arc, which will be right here, just like this. And now select smart dimension, and we'll have to define this between these two center points. Here will be 35 millimeters. Okay, and this will have the radius 12.5, actually no, I'm sorry, is 7.5. Okay, and now with trim entities command we'll have to cut these lines. Nice. Now we can close this and go to features and use extruded boss base, and here instead of blind we'll select mid plane, and here will be 30 millimeters, the thickness. Press here OK. Nice. Now we'll have to open a sketch on this face, normal 2, and here we'll have to make the next sketch. So first we'll select convert entities command, we'll convert this to arcs and this edge, and press OK. And now we'll select line and we'll make the next, first let's select center line, and we'll use dynamic mirror entities again, select the center line, and then select line to make the next sketch. We'll start like this, and now here we'll have to make another center point arc, which will have the center in that center point, and will be just like this, and then we'll select line and we'll close this sketch like this. Okay, here we can select to make this tangent, so select that point, select here, make tangent, and with smart dimension we'll define this sketch. Here the radius will be 12.5, and the dimension between these two lines will be 15 millimeters, and now this is fully defined. Now we'll go to features and we'll use extruded boss base, and here first direction, direction 1, the dimension will be 5 millimeters, and we'll have to select here direction 2, and here will be 35 millimeters, because we need this to be extruded 5 millimeters on each side. The thickness of this part is 30 millimeters, so 30 millimeters plus extra 5 is 35, and press OK. Nice. Now we'll have to make the holes, so open a sketch on this face, normal 2. Here we'll make two center lines, just like this, and then we'll start with a circle right here. Actually, we can make one also right here. Select this point and select this point and select here, make horizontal. Okay, and now we'll have to define this one. The diameter will be 4.5 millimeters, and the dimension between this center point and this center line will be 7.5. okay, and from this center point to this edge, here will be 5. Okay, now let's make these two equal, and now we'll use mirror to mirror this, and that mirror about we'll select this center line. Press here OK, and then select mirror again, select all three of them, and that mirror about this center line, and press OK. And now we have all six holes. And now we'll go to features and we'll use extruded cut, and here the depth will be 15 millimeters. And press OK. Nice. Now we have to apply some chamfer to this edge and to this edge. So go here to fillet on this arrow, select chamfer, and here the dimension I think will keep it 4 millimeters. Let's see. I think it's okay. And press OK. Nice. Now the base is done. Let's save this. So desktop base dual earring. Okay, and now we'll have to make the next part, which is the cap. So open a new part. And now we'll be making this part right here. You can see it here. So we'll make also this view, the sketch for this view, and then one extrusion, and then we'll make this other small sketch like we just did with the base. So let's begin. First we'll have to open a new sketch in the front plane. Here we'll select line and we'll make a rectangle. And now we'll have to define this. Here will be 11.5 millimeters. Here will be 70 millimeters. Okay. And now we'll have to make a center line in the middle of this rectangle. And now we'll select dynamic mirror entities. We'll select this center line and then we'll make a center point arc. This center point arc will be somewhere around here. Okay. And now we'll have to deactivate that and we'll have to dimension this. Here will be the radius will be 7.5 millimeters. Between these two will be 35. And I'll have to delete this extra line there. So select trim entities command and cut this. Nice. Now this is done. Go to features and use extruded boss base. And here the thickness will be also 30 millimeters. Press OK. And now we'll have to make this plain white first. Okay. And now we'll have to open another sketch on this face. Normal 2. And here we'll have to convert these edges first. So select convert entities command. Select these three edges. Convert them. And now we'll have to make the next sketch. So first select dynamic. Actually no, first let's make a center line. And then select dynamic mirror entities and we'll have to select this center line. And now we'll select center point arc again. We'll start from this center point, from this edge and until this edge. Nice, and now a line from this point to the center point and another line from this point to this point. And I'll have to define this arc. So this arc will have the radius 12.5 millimeters. Nice. Now we'll just go to features and we'll use extruded boss base and it will be first direction 5 millimeters and the second direction 35. And press here OK. Now I think we'll have to apply some chamfer on this edge and on this edge. So select chamfer, but the radius will be smaller. Let's try with 2 millimeters. I think it's okay. And press OK. And now we'll also have to make the holes. So select this face, open a sketch, normal too. And here we'll have to make those 6 holes. So we'll make them in the same way with the center line. Make this horizontal. Nice. And now we'll make first 2 like this and like this. Make these 2 points horizontal. Make these 2 holes equal. And we can make this point with this point also vertical. And now we'll dimension this. The diameter will be 4.5. And from this point to this center line will be 7.5. And now we'll just have to mirror this. So mirror these 2 first and mirror about this line, press it OK, and then mirror again these 2 and that mirror about this center line and press OK. Now go to features, use extruded cut, and here we'll select through all and press OK. Nice. Now let's save this. So this is the cap. Okay, and now we'll have to make the third part. So open a new part. This is the bushing. It's very easy. We can see it right here. This is it. So let's begin. And then the last part will be this bolt. So let's start. First we'll open a sketch in the front plane. Okay, and here we'll make a center line. And now we'll select line and we'll make the next sketch. And now we'll have to define this, so select smart dimensions. Here we'll use only the radius, and on the drawing we have the diameters, so we'll use half of the dimension. So first one is from this line to this line. Here is 11 millimeters divided by 2, and from this line to the center line here will be 7.5. And from this line here will be 10. This line here will have 5 millimeters, and this line here will have 40 millimeters. And now this is fully defined. Go to features and use revolved boss base and press OK. And now we have the bushing. Let's save this. This will be bushing 12. Okay, and now I'll have to make the last part, which is the bolt. So open a new part. We'll open a sketch in the front plane. And now we'll make a circle. This circle will have the diameter 4.5 millimeters. Now go to features and use extruded boss base. Here the length will be 25. Press OK. Let's make this plane white. Now open a sketch on this face, normal too, And here we'll select polygon and we'll make a polygon with 6 sides. Make it just like this. Then select this line, this one, and select here, make horizontal. Okay, and now we'll have to define this. So select smart dimension and we'll give here this dimension and will be 7 millimeters. Nice. And now select go to features and select extruded boss base, and here the thickness will be 4 millimeters. Press OK. Nice, this is almost done. Now we'll have to select top plane and we'll have to open a sketch in the top plane, normal tool, and now here we'll have to make a 3-point arc starting from this edge until this edge, just like this, and this will have the radius 0.7. Okay, and now we have to select this arc with this edge, select here, make tangent, and do the same on this side, make tangent, and now select line and close this sketch just like this. And now let's make a center line in the middle of this part. And now we'll have to use revolved cut, so go to features, select revolved cut. This center line is already selected right here, and press OK. Nice. Now we'll make here a chamfer, so let's select chamfer, let's see, 0.5 maybe, let's select this edge. Yep, I think this is okay. Press OK. And now if you want to make some fillet, go to this arrow, go to insert, go to annotations, and here you have just a second cosmetic thread. And now we'll have to select this edge. Here we can keep this, and here will be M4, the size M4 or M4, 0.7, and here at the end condition will be up to next, which will be up to this face, and press OK. And now if you want to see this fillet, go here to options, go to document properties, go to detailing and select here shaded cosmetic threads and press OK. And now this is the bolt. Let's save this one. So this is bolt to our bearing. And now I'll have to assemble them. So I will go back to the first part, the base, and we'll go to this arrow to file and then make assembly from part. We'll have to place it, so left click. Now let's make this plain white. Now we'll have to insert the other parts, so go to insert components and from here select with control pressed, actually the base is this one, bolt, bushing, cup, and that's all of them. And I will have to place them, so one click for each one of them. Nice. Now let's assemble them. First we'll select this face with this one and we'll select here coincide, and then select these two faces and select here concentric, and now this is not fully fixed because it's rotating, so we'll have to add one more mate, which will be from these two holes and will be concentric. And now this is not moving anymore, Now we'll have to insert this bushing, so select it, select this face then, and then here concentric, and now this face with this one and coincide. Nice. Now we'll have to make two of this, so with control pressed and left click and drag it, we will multiply these parts. So select that face with this one and select here concentric. Then this one with this one and select here coincide. Nice. Now we'll have to add this bolt, these balls, and all these six holes. So we'll have to rotate this, go up here to move component, rotate component, and then we'll rotate it like this. Press here OK. And now let's assemble it. We'll select this face with this one, select here make concentric, and now let's make five more of this. So with control pressed, left click and drag it, then do this until you have six bolts. Okay, now let's make here concentric also. Do the same for each one of these bolts. Okay, concentric, concentric, and here also concentric, and this is the last one. And now we'll have to select this face, and then with control pressed we select all of these faces from the bolts, and then we'll add one single mate which will be coincide, so all of these faces will coincide with the face from the cap. So coincide and press OK. Nice. And now this assembly is done. Now we'll have to make the exploded view. I'm gonna show you how to make this. So first we have here exploded view, click on it, and then we'll have to select all of these bolts, and you see these arrows are the directions where you can move these bolts or you can rotate them. So these bolts in reality will go up. So click on the arrow and drag it up. And now we have to take out this cap. So this will also go up, just like this. Then we'll take out these bushings, which I think this can go up and then can go right here, like this. And then this, you can keep it like this, or it can go down. Nice. And now press here OK. And now, as you can see, all of these are disassembled, to say like this. So we'll go here to assembly 2 or assembly 1, or what name you have here. Right click on it, select here collapse, and they are assembled. And then we want to animate this explosion, so right click again on this and select here animate explode, and here it is, the animated exploded view. And this is it for today. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. And if you like it, you can leave a like, you can subscribe if you want to see more, and I hope to see you in the next video. Thank you. Yeah.